Welcome to AM to PM, the show where two guys talk about stuff that's fascinating to extraterrestrials. Hi, E.T. Phone home. Ouch. Hi, I'm Andrew Monahan, an extraterrestrial from the first season of Big Brother Canada. And I'm Pete Monahan, not an extraterrestrial who failed to get on any season of Big Brother Canada. Maybe next year, but maybe not. What are we talking about this week, Pete? Well, today we're going to talk about Audrey's odd behavior. We're going to talk about love, Big Brother style, thanks to Austin. We're going to talk about the twingasm, and now that Lizzie has made it into the house. And we're going to talk, in the end, about life in the Big Brother house.
You know what? I just got that. Why? That's why it's called Lizzie, because it's Julia and Liz. I never knew that. Anyways,
and
Pete.
And now, you know, I'm the guy with the brains, and he's got the good looks.
So, Pete?
Yes, E.T.?
Let's get started!
So, Audrey's been evicted after exhibiting some very peculiar behavior. What do you think, Pete?
Well, I think Audrey broke a couple of barriers. She was obviously the first transgender house guest in the history of the show. Mm-hmm. Bravo. She was applauded for that. Yep. But also, she was the first person not to attend the veto ceremony when she was the replacement nominee. Yep. And the only reason she was because she screwed up and was extremely paranoid and got in a couple of big fights with Clay and Vanessa and had her feelings hurt.
Ugh.
And, you know, knew probably that she was going to go up. And so she went into the dining room and cried and said, oh, I don't want to play. Took her ball and left.
Yeah. Well, you know, I think the big reason that they didn't boot her out right then and there, a la Chima, I don't think it's the same at all, but the fact that they had that canned sort of visit to her family, they want to say, oh, you know, they had that planned, I would say, for a while, but like, oh, God, she's going to go, so let's show this, you know, a nice send-off, you know, great, and, you know, good for her, but I just got to say, probably one of the crappiest players I've ever seen, you know, when you say all this stuff, it's like, I never said that, it's like, you're crazy. So, you know, planting a seed for a lie is one thing, but blatantly lying to somebody, and then when it comes back, you're like, oh, it's come back now to get me? Obviously, so then they're going to boot you out.
Yep.
She was lucky to make it 4 weeks.
Yep, she was.
So, I see ya, not a very good player.
That's true, and it really hurts for all the people who want to get on the show. She took that spot.
I
she was somewhat
that.
Entertaining on the feeds, but it still sucks, so. Bummer.
See ya.
So Austin is willing to throw his game away for his love of Liz. Is it possible in the Big Brother house to find real love, Andrew?
Why you're asking me, I'll have no idea. They obviously set me up to potentially fall in love. That seemed to be my intro. I'd give up this game. They'd give up all the money for the woman I love and all this crap. But little did I know, they put me in as the oldest guy in with a bunch of youngsters. I think it's possible. Obviously, Em and Jillian are totally in love.
Yep.
There's other examples of love.
Yep.
But Austin is a mook. I'm sorry. He's a buffoon.
He has a girlfriend, too.
Does he have a girlfriend?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. What an idiot.
Yeah.
You know, it really comes to show you that people who are on Big Brother are complete idiots. Hi.
That's true.
And, you know, I know production loves, they love showmances.
They love showmances, yes. Well, because there's been a couple of big examples.
Absolutely.
Obviously, everybody focuses on Jeff and Jordan. And Brennan and Rachel.
Not so much.
And, you know, you go through every season. There's a showmance or two, but then there's lots of people. I always think about Drew and Diane.
Yeah.
This is sort of the reverse. Diane was willing to throw it away because she thought she had found Drew, and he gladly threw her aside and took Cowboy to the end and won.
Obviously.
They're not together anymore.
Kel Supreme.
The place is littered. Oh, we also forget about Danielle. Actually, this happened to Danielle twice. Danielle Donato. In season 8, she had a boyfriend. Then she had the hots for Nick. He was evicted. But then that obviously didn't work out. He actually went out with Jen, who was her sworn enemy.
He likes smart people.
And then she actually then wound up marrying Dominic from her season 13. So
I think it's hit or miss. I mean,
a lot more misses than hit.
And it's much like probably the Ginger Ninja's batting average. Below the Mendoza line.
Yes,
he
indeed.
Probably knows what I'm talking about, 604. Anyway, you know what?
If
you want to find love,
go on The Bachelor.
Yeah,
that's going to work out. So, Liz has won the B.O.B. She's safe this week, which means the twin twist is in full effect, and Julia's coming in. What do you think?
Well, I think it's great. Obviously, I'm sure Big Brother and CBS are very happy that it's come to fruition, even though it's an open secret. Everybody knows about it.
Yeah.
I kind of think that maybe those who are with them might come to regret it, although they'll say to themselves, well, it's just another number
to
vote for us, which is good. On the other side, they think it's two targets that we can get rid of.
They're never going to go against each other, ever, no matter what. Especially, this is one of those things, Austin,
yeah.
I see some people tweeting and saying, you know what would be great? If they backdoored each other. I'm sorry, it's not going to happen.
Listen, you know what, Pete? We're twins. We have the same DNA, as they said on the show. We would never go against each other.
Of course not. That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard, right?
You know, you're more likely to get a showmance to stab each other in the back before you're going to get twins to do it. So
yes.
They're together. You talk about ride or die. You know, they said womb mates. That's the way it is. So they're together. Austin, I'm sorry I said it before, he is an idiot. I like him, but he's a crap Ola player.
Oh, yes, just, absolutely.
These people are, you know, they want crappy players. That's why they got people like
some
me.
Some drama. But,
want, you know, drama, but yeah, he's... I love the fact that Vanessa was, I think it was Vanessa who said, you know, his Judas, because that's his alter ego.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't know. Did she actually know that, or if she just sort of pulled that out? Anyway, whatever. They're either not long for this game, or they are. They're obviously, I sense them being put up against each other. Absolutely. Most likely. That's going to happen. But,
yep, that'll
happen. I'm happy that they're there, because, hey, if twins are a hot topic, watch out for me on Big Brother Canada 4. I will be tweeting from my home.
That's right.
One of us on AM to PM has actually lived in the Big Brother Canada house. It wasn't me. I did visit. Please remember. What was it like, Andrew?
It was pretty amazing. I mean, you know, thinking back to it, because, you know, when I watch Big Brother Canada or Big Brother US, you always think about, wow, I was actually in the Big Brother house.
Yes, I think that too.
And we always talked about the life, you know, what it was like. That's what people always ask. But it's, you know, there's a lot of downtime because, you know, once you get an HOH and nominations, that's Thursday, Friday nominations, followed by a very quick veto.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm not talking about BOB here because I only know Canada.
Yes.
But then, you know, the replacement is put up
probably or not
by Saturday or Sunday at the latest.
Yep.
And then you've got
until Thursday.
So if you're in a place like I was, playing it, you know, low key in the beginning. Not getting nominated. And not
Let's make some jokes.
Not rustling any feathers or ruffling any feathers or being on the show at all. And then all of a sudden you're like, hey, what are we going to do here? I don't know. Let's do whatever we want. I went for multiple swims by myself because no one wanted to hang out with me.
It was also a sweltering sauna. I did visit for a very short time.
It was so hot. So I was always 40-degree clad. Those guys were always working out. I think, hey, AJ, let's go on. Have chats. So that's what you did. Is chatted. I heard a lot of crappy stories from a lot
of crappy
people. You
couldn't nap, though. That's the difference, right?
We could nap early, and then Topaz could put the kibosh.
She was the nap saboteur.
Exactly. But you know, but then you would just be like, hey, maybe I'll. And you see James doing it right now. It's like, this old country boy needs to get some eating. You know what I mean? So I was just like, hey, what are you going to do? I don't know. Let's go make some burgers. You know, I just always remember people, man, there's no food left. And I was like, what the hell are you talking about? There's a load of frozen burgers in here. There's all these hot dogs, all this stuff. You know, I was in with a bunch of clean living health fanatics or whatever. You know, me and AJ.
You were
like,
dirty living.
I was a dirty living, you know.
Hooch fanatic.
Hooch fanatic, exactly. So, but living in there, outside of the game, you're just trying to kill time.
Right, and trying not to get cornered by someone saying, are you going to vote for me?
That was the first thing, is like either avoiding the person who was annoying who you were hoping to get out, which maybe, let's say it was Suzette for that one week, you're just like, oh my God, just let her go.
Yeah.
You know, the week after, you know, after she was saved. And then the other time was then somebody who you liked, who now is going to be evicted, who is trying to get your vote. Hi, Alec. You're like, hey, man. It's like, man, you turned into a real knob. He pissed me off so much. I was like, man, why didn't you like him? I was like, man. He should have just, if only a couple of weeks earlier, would have said, hey, you want to be in an alliance? I'd have been like, no problem.
Yes.
And it would be a totally different conversation.
Would have been much shorter.
Of course it would have. Yes. But, you know, he just, you know, so living in there outside of the game is just boring.
Yes.
You're just trying to fill your time with random stupid conversations. Those guys tried to create games and stuff like that, which we played.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Could you sit down and tell each other the synopsis of a movie that you'd seen?
I know that you used to do that when you travel and stuff like that, but I'm pretty sure, because when we had the movie we watched,
The Evil Dead,
you know, we told each other about it,
and
they were like, hey, tell us when. They're like, okay, now you're done, you can't talk about it anymore, because, well, obviously they were promoting that movie. They're like, hey, guess what happens in the end? What happens? They all die, or whatever.
And they're evil.
Exactly, and they're dead. So I don't know. Long story long.
Great.
It was fun living.
Great insights.
Yeah. Well, I'm telling you, they said not to talk about it.
I had one question. No answer. I don't know.
Don't talk smack about it, because I remember that. Man, the movie was so crap. I was like,
oh, yeah, no.
You can't say that. You know, they're like, oh, so scary. I was like,
me. I guess you said, can you tell me the premise of that movie they called? I can't tell you the name of it, but it reminds me of the fake tricks. There's a guy, his name is
yeah,
Cleo.
Yeah, but not like that.
And
Cleo and Leo? No, obviously. But, you know, life in the Big Brother house,
I mean, that's what everybody wants to do. Who would get in there and scheme and all this stuff? Really, what we want to do is get in and be like, hey, guess what? Someone is going to do my laundry for the sheets. I'm, not your actual laundry, but people didn't know how to do their own laundry. But you got, you can do laundry all day long. We're like,
great, fine.
We didn't take advantage of...
You got in there, and we're like...
yeah, I know. I don't do laundry at home. We didn't take advantage of those. It was like all this...
That's
Gary one day. Yeah, Gary did one day, took out all the appliances, you know, all the little sort of whatever, you know. Like, hey, there's a Cuisinart, there's this. We didn't use any of it. I should have just been like...
This is SkyMall.
Yeah, look at this. I should have just been making crazy food all the time.
Sure, Alan, absolutely.
And Nicole from season two.
Yes.
I should have done that.
Looking for the banner plan that says you cheated my will.
Anyway, life in the Big Brother house is pretty crazy. I hope you all get a chance to do it, especially this guy.
Not going to happen.
It's that time of the week, the douchebag of the week. Austin has been playing a horrible game. He is saying some things and doing some stuff, and I don't know, it's just really, really creepy. So, the douchebag of the week is Alec Beal. You're the emperor of douche, and still a giant douchebag. Well, that concludes another fine episode, if I must say so myself, of AM to PM. Thank you all for watching. We appreciate all of the support from all of you, and you know who you are. Pete, what do you think?
Yes, it's me and you.
And, I've watched it 500 times.
I've also watched it 500
times. Hey, that's the 1,000 views.
Anyway, I'm going to put a subscribe button here. So please,
we've got
a
new page.
I did.
No, you didn't.
I did on the first. There's a subscribe. Anyway, whatever. We have like 27 subscribers on our new page, AM to PM. Thanks for watching. We're going to keep doing it. And look out for lots of other great stuff that may or may not be coming from us.
See you guys. Bye. Talk a big brother, talk a big brother.